They stole us, they sold us, and they owe us. Everybody say it. They stole us, they sold us, they owe us. They stole us, they sold us, they owe us. They stole us, they sold us, they owe us. What do we want? When do we want it? What do we want? When do we want it? What do we want? When do we want it? What do we want? 40 acres. 40 acres. 40 acres. 40 acres. 40 acres. We're here today to demand reparations for black people in this country who are the descendants of Africans forced to labor as slaves in this country for over 400 years. And economists have calculated how much money is owed to black people in the United States for the 4.5 centuries of enslavement in this country. I bet you nobody knows what the number is. There is a number. You close, you in the ballpark. Don't be talking about no $1 million for no reparations. It's way more than $1 million. You gotta put your mind in the trillions. In the trillions, what they owe black people. In fact, some economists have calculated the value of the wealth produced by enslaved people in this country at $14 trillion. $14 trillion. How many people know what a trillion is? A million, let me get it right. A billion is 1,000 million. A billion is 1,000 million. And a trillion is 1,000 billion. Black people are owed $14 trillion for the wealth that was produced by our ancestors. And that's not enough, but we'll take it. we won't refuse it. And I'm calling on the entire congressional delegation of the state of New Jersey. We, the People's Organization for Progress, we support H.R. 40, the reparations bill initially introduced by Congressman John Conyers in 1989. The reparations bill called H.R. 40 in the House, and I believe it's 1037 in the Senate, S-1037, I believe, in the Senate, because the Make a Law has got to be passed in the House and in the Senate, would establish a commission to study the issue of reparations. So we support the commission to do the study, but the bill is 30 years old. We've been talking about reparations for almost 200 years. So today I am calling on the congressman from New Jersey to introduce legislation to make $14 trillion in reparations to African Americans and to make direct compensation to the descendants. You hear what I'm saying? We want direct compensation. People say we don't want a check. I want my check. People talking about we don't need a check. We'll set up a fund and find some worthy cause. I want a check. I want, just like they gave reparations to other people, we're not the only people that have asked for reparations. A whole lot of people have already got reparations. The Japanese that were unjustly concentration camps during World War II. They have already received reparations. Every Japanese family that had a member incarcerated had received $20,000 from the United States government. And that happened in the 1940s. You know who made that reparations possible? Ronald Reagan. The reparations to the Japanese happened during the Reagan administration. And other people have gotten reparations. But we're here today to say that it's time for black people in this country who are the descendants of those who were enslaved to receive payment, not just for slavery. If it was slavery, that's just the $14 trillion. What about the 100 years of Jim Crow segregation and racial terror? People talk about Black Wall Street, about Tulsa. There were many Black Wall Streets. Many people don't know that. They think there was only one rich black community in America. There were many black well-to-do communities. There was Rosewood. There was Tulsa. There was Wilmington, North Carolina. And what happened when the black people got a little bit of money? They burned the black people town down. They burned Black Wall Street down. So they tell you, pull yourself up by your own bootstraps, as if that's humanly possible. Like, we need to research where that came from. Pull yourself up by your own bootstraps. But somehow we did it. And when we got wealthy, they burned our stores down. They burned our businesses down. They burned our bank down. Can you imagine, black people, we had our own banks. They burned them down. We had banks. People say, you should have your own banks. Well, we had our own banks, and they burned them down. We had our own banks. We had our own stock exchange. Tulsa had a stock exchange. Can you believe that? There was black people with so much money in the Greenwood section of Tulsa, Oklahoma. They had their own everything, airplanes, everything. You can see the pictures. You don't have to believe me. Just Google it. They're actually photographs from the time of Greenwood, 1920s. Black people with cars all up and down the main street. It wasn't like one black family had a car. Cars all up and down the street. There was a black man on a plane, on factories, on banks. What happened? They burned them down. They burned them down in Tulsa. They burned them down, dropped a bomb on them. Dropped a bomb on Black Wall Street. The first bomb dropped within the borders of the United States was dropped on a black community here in the United States, Greenwood, Oklahoma. Greenwood, which was part of Tulsa, Oklahoma. That's right. They threw a bomb out of an airplane. That's right. So don't tell us to create your own institutes, because when we do, you burn them down. They don't want black people to have wealth. If we get wealth, they'll find a way to get it back. We demand reparations. We're here today, the People's Organization for Progress, and we want you to come over and register to vote. Because the more black registered voters we have, the stronger we will be to make our demand for reparations. So come on over here and sign up and register to vote. But we're here today to talk about reparations. Reparations for 400 years of enslavement. Do you know, people say, well, the New York Times says slavery began in 1619. But the first Africans didn't come here in 1619. The first Africans came here in 1512, I think it was, when the Spanish. No, North Carolina. North Carolina. And then they left the colony that they had set up in North Carolina, and they set it up in St. Augustine, Florida. St. Augustine, Florida. So St. Augustine in Florida has been there since the 1500s. Now, the colony that the Spanish set up in the Carolinas, the slaves rebelled, and they killed their masters. They killed their masters. I bet you haven't seen a movie about that, right? You see a lot of movies with a lot of killers. But have you ever noticed you never see a movie about slaves killing their masters? You never see that. You remember the movie Spartacus? How many people remember Spartacus? What wasn't they? Kirk Douglas. Kirk Douglas led a slave rebellion in Rome. And it's a true story. The story of Spartacus is a true story, by the way. When I took Latin at Arts High School, I learned about the Pyrrhic Wars. There were three. They were called the Servile Wars. Three slave rebellions in Rome, and Spartacus was the third. But Spartacus failed because he got sold out by the pirates. He had made a deal to get out of Italy, and they were supposed to come pick him up. But do you know what? This week is the anniversary of the Haitian Revolution. The only revolution in the history of humanity where the enslaved people who were black, just like us, they rose up against their French masters and they overthrew and defeated France, the superpower of its time. But you never see a movie about Toussaint Louverture, do you? You see that movie about Spartacus, but you know why? Because they don't want you to see a movie of black people killing their white slave masters. Oh no, you can't see that movie. No sir, no sir. And you ain't seen a movie about Nat Turner, have you? Nat Turner's rebellion, the anniversary is this month. August 21st is the anniversary of Nat Turner's rebellion, but you've never seen a movie about Nat Turner's rebellion. Come over here and register to vote. Register to vote. Come on over. Register to vote. Register to vote. We got to get Trump out, but we also want reparations. See, because the Democrats could be in, the Republicans have been in, but we haven't got reparations yet. Reparations for the descendants of Africans enslaved in America. We're here today to demand reparations, and we're here today to demand not only H.R. 40, but we want legislation introduced that will result in direct payments to the descendants of Africans enslaved in this country. That's right. Direct pay. Everybody else got paid. Why should black people be any different? Oh, we're going to set up a special fund. See, that's racism talking. That's racism. You can give reparations to other people, but if you give something to black people, you got to set up a special fund that Bill and Hillary Clinton can manage for you. Like they managed for the Haitians. Remember when they told Bill and Hillary to collect all the money? What happened to that money? $3 billion was collected for the people in Haiti. You know what happened? They built six houses. You mean to tell me it cost $3 billion to build six houses in Haiti? We want reparations. We want reparations now. Reparations for the descendants of enslaved Africans in the United States of America. We want direct payments. I want to know what congressperson has the guts. Even Marion Williamson, who ran for Congress, at least she put out a number. It wasn't the right number, but shoot him in the legs, Biden. He said he wasn't for reparations. Why are you laughing? When they asked Biden about police brutality, and by the way, for the record, I'm voting for Biden-Harris, but I got to tell the truth. When they asked Biden about police brutality, what did he say? He said, oh, maybe we shouldn't shoot him in the heart, we should shoot him in the leg. That was Biden's answer on police brutality. And that's not made up. You can Google that. I'm not making this up. That's right. You notice we want reparations. Honk those horns. Reparations. Honk those horns. Honk those horns. That's right. Reparations. Reparations now. Honk those horns. Right down the street is a bank. The name of that bank is the Wells Fargo Bank. Everybody look where I'm pointing. Wells Fargo. That bank owes you reparations. Wachovia. Wachovia was developed from the Georgia Railroad and Bank Company and the Charlottesville Bank Company. Those two companies profited from the enslavement of black people. Wells Fargo owes black people reparations. So the next time you go in there to take cash your check, tell Wells Fargo I want my reparations. Tell Wells Fargo I want my reparations. Write a note and give it to the teller. Say, oh, by the way, I want my reparations. I'm here today to expose Wells Fargo's role. And the same Wells Fargo's bank that profited from slavery is the same bank that's foreclosing on black people's houses. The same bank that's closing on black people's houses. The highest rate of foreclosure in New Jersey, Wells Fargo. Wells Fargo taking black people's homes. So when you go in there, you tell Wells Fargo. I tell you, there's another bank down the street. It's on this side. Chase. Chase Bank owes you reparations. The bank that Chase was created from also profited from slavery. I tell you who else profited from slavery. Many insurance companies that are still around today. Insuring slaves was big business. See, you got to understand this thing about slavery. You think about slaves and you think about cotton. But you don't think about the end result. The end result of slavery was the enrichment of the slave masters and the enrichment of this country. In 1860, do you know what the biggest industry in America was? In 1860? The biggest industry in America in 1860 was slavery. Slavery was an industry. This is what made American slavery different from all other slaveries that existed previously. It was a business. In the old days, if one people conquered another, the conquered people would be made slaves. In this slavery, you were turned, your black body was turned into a product. That's right, you were capital. And the largest form of capital in the United States in 1860 was the capital invested in the industry of slavery. Don't let anybody tell you that America don't owe you anything. America owes you everything. If we were to actually collect on what is owed to us, America couldn't even pay it right now. America would go bankrupt. It would go bankrupt. They say America is the richest country in the world. Well, who made it rich? Black people made it rich. You made it rich, picking that cotton. You made it rich, planting that rice. You made it rich, cutting that cane. You made America rich. You made them wealthy. And what did you get in return? You got the whip and you got the lash. You got the chains and you got the shackles. That's right, that's what you got in return. But I'm here today, I'm a descendant of slaves in America. My grandfather was born into slavery. I'm a descendant of slaves and I'm here today to demand reparations. And I want reparations not only for black people in America, I want reparations for black people wherever we were enslaved. That's right. But see, we got to go to different slave masters. The black people enslaved in Jamaica got to go to the British. They got to go to the British. The black people enslaved in Haiti, they got to go to the French. The black people enslaved down there in Brazil. And do you know that the largest black population outside of Africa is in Brazil? The black people in Brazil, they got to go to Portugal. We each got to go to the slave master that enslaved us. And here in America, we got to go to Uncle Sam. And what do we got to say to Uncle Sam? Uncle Sam, pay up. It's time to pay. The bill is due. This is what Martin Luther King was talking about. He said, America giving you a bad check. A check mark, insufficient funds. We're here to collect. The account is full. And it's time for reparations for the enslaved people in this country. They took your land. After the Civil War, you were supposed to get 40 acres and a mule. That was the plan. It was in a bill called H.R. 29. H.R. 29 said that every black person would receive 40 acres. Or every black person that fought in the Civil War would receive 40 acres. Boy, you know what happened after that. When Lincoln put that forward, we said, nah, nah. They went out and got the gun. See, they tell you to play by the rules. They never play by the rules. Their game is power by any means necessary. So what happened to Lincoln? They assassinated Lincoln. They shot him in Ford's Theater. Just mysteriously, the president's guards were gone, and somebody just walked up there to the balcony and shot Lincoln and shot the Secretary of State. I forgot what the Secretary's name was. And Lincoln was dead. Seward. Seward. Secretary of State Seward. But Seward lived, and they killed Lincoln. And then who became vice president? Andrew Johnson became the vice president. And Andrew Johnson was from where? He was from Tennessee. He was from the South. And his first act as president was to overturn the executive orders that you were supposed to get land. They knew they couldn't free slaves and not give them a way to survive, not give them any land. So all the land that General Sherman had took from the slave masters, 400,000 acres, was taken back. All the promises that were made were broken. And you know what Frederick Douglass said about emancipation? I know we think emancipation was a great thing. You know what Frederick Douglass, the great abolitionist, said? Frederick Douglass said we were free to starve. Free to starve. That's what emancipation looked like without reparations. Free to starve. You know what happened to many slave enslaved people? They went back to the plantation because they couldn't find a way to live. And they became a new form of slave called sharecroppers. And that's a new form of slavery. And we've been sharecropping ever since. Sharecropping on the land and sharecropping in the factory. Well, how come we can't get up the ladder? Because we have no generational wealth, because we were enslaved. But we're here to say we want our money back. We want our stolen labor back. We want the wealth that we created. We want it back. We don't want it back in five generations. Don't write no bill about to me. Write no legislation talking about in 20 years, black people will receive reparations. In 10 years, in 5 years, in 3 years, until we want our reparations now. Send the check now. You sent out checks to everybody else. You just finished sending out checks. You sent out so many checks, you couldn't keep up with the checks. They were sending checks to dead people. You think I'm making this up? Am I making this up? They sent out $1 billion worth of stimulus checks to dead people. To dead people. They got money to send for dead people, but when you say reparations, all of a sudden they ain't got no money. They had $1 trillion to bail out the company. The money was supposed to be for small businesses, was supposed to be for mom and pop stores. Who was the first in line? The big hogs was in line. Who was the first in line? Trump's friends. Trump's friends was in line. All the friends that he had that owned companies, they got the stimulus money, and what did the mom and pop store get? Not a damn thing. What did the shoe store get? Not a damn thing. What did the lottery store get? Not a damn thing. All the money went to people who already got money. We want reparations. We want it now. I want my 40 acres. I don't want a mule. I want a John Deere. 40 acres and a tractor. We in the 21st century. I can't do nothing with a mule. I need a tractor. 40 acres and a tractor. I want my land, and I want it now. And if you can't give me the land, then give me the money. Can you imagine how different our situation would be if black people, if every black enslaved person had received 40 acres, had received land? Do you imagine our situation would be totally different? We would own the whole South. The South would probably be a black country by now if we had all gotten the 40 acres and all gotten the mule. But the racists weren't there. See, you think the South lost the war. They tell you the North won the war.
here today to tell you the South won the war. The South lost on the battlefield, but they won on the political field. Because what happened? What happened after they passed the 13th Amendment and the 14th Amendment and the 15th Amendment? They put us back in slavery. What do you think prison is? Prison is slavery. Read the 13th Amendment. Read it. All you got to do is read the 13th Amendment. I want you to read it. It says everybody is free except for people convicted of a crime. That's what it says. So they've been busy for the last 150 years re-enslaving their runaway slaves. They done caught you and they done put you on the plantation in Northern State, the plantation in Southern State, the plantation in Eastern State, the plantation down there on 1 and 9, the plantation in Trenton State. That's what these prisons are. These prisons are nothing but plantations, and you nothing but a slave. You go in there, you think you this and that. When it's time to eat, they tell you to eat. When it's time to sleep, they tell you to sleep. When they open that door, you go in, and they lock the door behind you, and your slave ass is in jail for all night. You nothing but a slave in jail. That's what the 13th Amendment did. We want reparations. And there's no freedom, brothers and sisters, unless there's economic freedom. If you don't have economic freedom, if you don't have money, how far are you going to go? If you don't have money, how well are you going to live? If you don't have money, you can't pay a doctor. You can't pay a dentist. But for the last 150 years, they have kept us in a state of servitude. A state of servitude. And you feel it now. You feel it more than you've ever felt it before. You think just because you can walk from here to the corner, you're free. I'm telling you, you do something, you'll be locked up before the sun goes down. But if the other people do something, they never go to jail. The police kill. They kill with impunity. They killed George Floyd. Is that police in jail? The police that killed Breonna Taylor. They went into the EMT workers, went into a bedroom. She was in the house. They had a no-knock warrant. They kicked open the door, and they went in and killed that sister. They shot her 8 times in the bed. And the man they were looking for was already in jail. You think I couldn't make this up. It's worse than a science. Maybe I should be a science fiction writer, because a science fiction story is not as fantastic as some of the stuff that happens to black people. We kill while walking. We kill while sleeping. We kill while eating. We kill while drinking. We kill while breathing. We kill going here and we kill going there, and they keep killing us and they keep doing it because we don't stand up and fight back. It's time for us to stand up and fight back. It's time for men to start being men. And it's time for women to stand right next to us. Stop trying to hold your woman down. She can be a freedom fighter too. We need to be side by side fighting for freedom. That's right. What did Malcolm X say? A nation can only rise as high as its woman, because the woman raises the children. And you busy trying to hold your woman down. Raise your woman up, because our children are raised up when she's raised up, and you're raised up too. We want reparations. We want it now. If they got $1 trillion to bail out the banks, they got $1 trillion to bail out the corporations, they got $1 trillion to give the rich tax breaks, then they got money for reparations. We want reparations. Right now, our brothers and sisters are in New York City. They marching to Columbus Circle, demanding reparations. When I get enough people together, we're going to march here too. We're going to march down to Wells Fargo. In fact, we might set up a picket line in front of Wells Fargo so nobody can get in and out of Wells Fargo. So the bank president can't get out. He want to get out. He see people coming down the street. We going to block the entrance. He not going to get out till we get our reparations. That's right. We want reparations. We want it now. What is reparations? Reparation is restitution. Reparations is compensation. Reparation is payment for labor, for the wealth that was stolen from your labor. Your labor, you picked that cotton. about slavery. I see some of y'all don't want me to talk, but I'm going to talk about slavery. You tell me about everybody else's oppression. All in school, I learned about all these people that fought against oppression, but they never showed me my people fighting against oppression. But we're here today to fight against oppression. And we're here, the People's Organization for Progress. We want you to come over here and register to vote. You got to register and vote. We got to get Trump out. He's the biggest slave master of all. He acts like a slave master. He don't even try to fool you. He lets you know he's a slave master. That's right, we got to get Trump out. He's the most dangerous president alive. Don't let anybody tell you he's a clown. He ain't no clown. That's all an act to make you think he's stupid, to make you think you shouldn't be on your guard, to make you think you don't have to defend yourself. All that's an act. These people are monsters. They are calculators. They are planners. They're planning for how to keep us oppressed for the next 400 years. You think they want to let you go? They don't ever want to let you go. They want you to keep, first they want you to work on the plantation. And when the plantations went away, they want you to work in the factories. And when the factories go away, whatever else is work to do, you're going to have to do it now. Honk your horns for justice. I mean, come over here and sign up. Register to vote. Come on over, register to vote. Register to vote. See, we messing up the voter registration now. We messing up the voter registration. Come on over. Thank that brother. Help that brother right there. He wants to register. Thank you. Thank you. Come on over. Register to vote. This is the People's Organization for Progress. We are no Johnny come lately. We out here every Saturday. How many years have we been out here with you? How many years have we been out here trying to bring you the truth? You've seen us out here every Saturday. And you see us on Monday down at the Federal Building. We've been with you all these years. We're no Johnny come lately. So when we tell you something, you can write a book on it. Come on over and sign up. Register to vote. Come on over. Come on over and register to vote. Do it right now.
To the people, what do we want?
Justice.
No reparations today. What do we want?
Reparations.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Reparations.
When do we want it?
Now.
We want reparations for our ancestors that built the White House. Do you know the White House, where the president lives, was built by enslaved people? The White House that's been the capital of the country for the last 200 years, it was built with slave labor. And this is not a guess. There's actually a registry that you can see of the names of enslaved people that helped to build the White House. Like, they had to keep a registry so that they would know if anybody ran away. That's why they kept a registry. They keep a registry because they're for history. They want to know, we had 10 slaves out there this morning. We got 10 slaves tonight. Everybody's still here. The first 12 presidents, listen, the first 12 presidents of the United States owned slaves. 8 of them had slaves in the White House. We're not making this up. See, they didn't tell you that in elementary school. Well, tell me the name of your teacher that told you that the White House was built with slave labor. They didn't tell you that. Tell me the teacher, the name of the teacher that told you the name of one president besides George Washington that owned slaves. And by the way, George Washington was one of the biggest slaveholders in the country. He had 6 plantations. George Washington, the president, and he was a mean slave master. That take his picture out. You walk around with his picture all day in your pocket. Washington, which one is he on? The dollar? The dollar bill. This one. This one. This Washington. This one. That's him. He whipped slaves. He whipped slaves. You know, when I was in elementary school, we were actually in a play. We were in a play, and I had to play George Washington.
and I had that line, right? Who chopped down the cherry tree? I could never tell a lie. He was lying all day long. He was the biggest liar in Virginia. Go read some of the letters that some of the people wrote about Washington when he was still alive. He whipped his slaves. His slaves hated him so much, they were always looking for a way to escape. You know what Washington's cook's name was? He was a slave. Guess what his name was? His name was Hercules. The name of the cook, the enslaved cook that Washington had, his name was Hercules. And guess what? Hercules ran away and got away and stayed away. Washington had another slave, an enslaved woman, who was the slave to his wife. She, what was her name?
Ona.
Ona got away. Washington tried to get Ona back till the day he died. He would not rest because Ona got away. Thomas Jefferson was a pedophile. What was his sister's name? Sally Hemings was 13 years old when he took her. And he built a little room that nobody else could see. Go down there, it's in Monticello. Don't believe anything I say. Look it up, take your phone out and Google it. He had a little room off of his bedroom that had no window, that he kept Sally Hemings in there so he could have her whenever he wanted her. Jefferson raped our mothers. Washington raped our mothers. All of these slave masters raped our mothers. And you walking around here like nothing is wrong. I'm telling you, if black people really knew this history, this country would have been burnt to the ground a long time ago. I know you don't like to hear that kind of talk, but if you knew the real truth, you don't know the truth. What they taught you in school was a pack of lies. It was a lie in the morning, it was a lie in the afternoon, and it was a lie in the evening. I went to South 17th Street School in Newark. Say, you know where it is? Across the street from Westside Park. Every fall, you could go up to South 17th Street School and you see the children. They made us cut out little Ninas, little Pintas, and little Santa Marias. What was the Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria? Those were the ships that Columbus was on. They were slave ships. Slave ships. Columbus took slaves on his first voyage. There wasn't even no Africans here yet. It was the Taino Indians, the Taino people. He enslaved them and sent 60 of them back home to the king and queen of Spain, Isabella and Ferdinand. For 100 years before they enslaved black people, they enslaved the Native Americans, the Taino, down there in the Caribbean. The Taino, the Arawak, the Carib, the Carib. That's why they call it Caribbean, because the original people were the Caribs. They wasn't from France. The original people wasn't from Europe. They were the indigenous people that came over here, 15,000, 35,000. Every time they do the research, they're going back further and further. 35,000 years ago, people came here, and they weren't Europeans. And Columbus was a monster. He was a monster. When your children come home singing about Columbus, you should say, no, baby, don't sing that name. Tell them that was a slave master. Do you know he skinned Indians alive? Flailing. It was called flailing. Flailing. When you flail, when you took the skin off a human being. They talk about the Germans and what the Germans did to the Jews, and it was wrong. But listen, do you know that there was a traffic for human skin during the colonial era? Colonizing masters walked around in shoes made from the skin of enslaved people. If you don't believe me, look it up. You don't have to believe me. Look it up for yourself. Read K. Capitalism and Slavery by Eric Williams.
There you go.
Look, read Castro, Columbus to Castro by Eric Williams. Read Open the Veins of Latin America by Eduardo Galeano. Read the works of Dr. John Henry Clark. Read Ivan Van Sertima. They came before Columbus. It's no big secret. The only thing is you don't know it. And you gotta go read it. That's why we're here to demand reparations. We want reparations. We want you to come over and register and vote too, but we want reparations. And reparations is payment. Our people, do you know they literally worked our people to death? The doctors have done research on the remains of enslaved people that they have found in graves here in the United States. And there's a mental condition, a physical condition when the muscle is detached from the bone. When you work so hard, literally, your muscles pop off of your tendons. Many slaves had that condition. Many slaves, they worked us to death. Y'all always see these pictures of old slaves, right? Old slaves with gray hair, sitting eating watermelons. Most slaves didn't live to be old. They were worked to death. Most slaves died before they were 30 years old. They were worked to death here in America. And on these same plantations that they turn in Cesare, they turning them into bed and breakfast. Did you know that? You can go and have a bed, go and get a room at a bed and breakfast at a former slave plantation down there in South Carolina. We should go down there with some torches. Right now, somebody give me a train ticket. I want to get on the first train to South Carolina. I want to look like Nat Turner with that torch. I want to go to Master's house, and I want to set Master's house on fire. I want to set it on fire with him in it. I want to set it on fire with Master in it and with Missy in it too. Master and Missy, set both their asses on fire, because you know what? They just came out with a book. They own slaves too. Talking about the white women that own slaves. See, you just think it was white men that own slaves. You know how Washington came into his wealth? He came into his wealth through marriage to Martha. Martha had all the slaves. When he married Marcia, he doubled the number of slaves that he had. Marcia was a slave owner. And Marcia had promised to free some people. And most of the time, the master didn't keep their promise. Not only didn't they free you, they took your wife. You know where the slogan, where the saying comes, I was sold up the river? That comes from slavery. I was sold up the river. That means that they took you from your family, put your butt on a boat up the Mississippi or down to Louisiana, to a worse plantation that you were already on. That's right. I was sold up the river. That comes from enslaved. Look, I can't tell y'all too much. Because if I tell you too much, there might be a riot out here. And I promised Roz Baraka that we wouldn't tear up no stores today. But if I keep talking to you, I know you're going to get mad. But I don't want you to get mad. I want you to get organized. We got to get organized. We got to get organized. You know what our biggest problem is? We're not unified and we're not organized. Let me tell you something. If black people would unify with ourselves and with our allies, this thing would fall tomorrow. They only rule because they understand how to divide and conquer. That's what they understand. Let's make them fight each other. Let's make the light-skinned ones not like the dark-skinned ones. Let's make the Haitians not like the African-Americans, and let's make the African-Americans not like the Africans. Let's make the ones up north not like the ones down south. Let's make the ones that got education not like the ones that don't have education. Oh yes, that's how they keep you divided. They keep you hate, and the greatest division of all, guess what the greatest division of all is? is to divide you against yourself, to make you hate yourself. They make you hate your brother and sister, and then they make you hate yourself. They make you hate the image of yourself. You look in the morning, look in the mirror every morning, and you don't like the image that you see, because that's not the image that's in the movie. That's not the image that's on the TV. When I was a little boy, they used to always try to make me hold my lips in, because we weren't supposed to have thick lips. We were supposed to have a little bit of my people, hold your lips in. Or when my relatives would see me, they would say, they would pinch me on my nose. All day long, pinch me on my nose. Because they didn't like a flat nose. They want us to have a straight nose. You know, I used to go get my mother's stockings and cut up my mother's stocking and make a stocking cap. And then I went and got some Nunez or some Dixie Peach pomade. And if they didn't have no New Nile and no Dixie Peach, I got some Vaseline. And I put that Vaseline in my hair. I put that Vaseline in that Dixie Peach and then pulled that stocking cap down so tight that when I woke up in the morning and took the stocking cap off, there'd be a line across my forehead. Why? Because I was trying to straighten my hair. I didn't like the hair that God gave me. I wanted straight hair. I didn't want curly hair. I didn't want black hair. And if I couldn't get straight hair, I'd go buy some straight hair and put it on my head. You know? They taught us. And then James Brown came out with a record. And what did James Brown say? Say it loud. I'm black and I'm proud. And so we were tired. We wasn't going to be hating ourselves anymore. We're going to be proud of our black skin. Proud of our nose. Proud of our lips. Proud of our hair, proud of ourselves. That's right, you can't do nothing if you hate yourself. Stop hating yourself. Be proud of who you are. Let me tell you something. Black people are great people. We're great people. We gave civilization to the world. That's right, I'll debate anybody on this question. They didn't have engineering before they built. Why do you think the pyramids still stand after 5,000 years? They're so crazy with racism and white supremacy, now they're trying to say that aliens built the pyramids.
Come on.
And they're saying it in strange places. You would think that on the History Channel, you would get history. They talking about the aliens on the History Channel, that aliens built the pyramid. There's nowhere in the world that black people could build these pyramids that could build something that could stand for 5,000 years. I'm telling you, we gave them mathematics. What did we Plato, we Socrates, they tell you where they went. They said, we went to the land of the burnt faces. That's what Plato and Socrates and Aristotle said. You can even look at the buildings. When you look at the columns of the buildings in Greece, and then you go to Egypt, and you look at the columns on the buildings in Egypt, it's the same damn column. They went there, read Black Athena. There's a book called Black Athena. Talks about the Egyptian origins of Greek and Roman civilization. The whole gods, all them gods, they got them from us and renamed them. You look up in the sky and what do you see? You see Orion the Hunter, right? That's the constellation they taught you about, right? The one with the three stars in it. Do you know what the original name was? Osiris. It was Osiris. The Greeks changed it to Orion. The original name of the constellation is Osiris. So if you know the true story, when you look up in the night sky, you see the black man in the sky, Osiris. And if you go look for Osiris, all the Egyptian imagery of Osiris is black. He is black. He's a black man. I know it makes some people uncomfortable to hear this, but the truth is the truth. I don't take away, Europeans made many contributions to civilization. I'm not arguing about Europeans. I believe in the equality of all people. The problem is that they're trying to teach us that we are inferior. That's the problem. And we're not inferior to anybody. We're not inferior to anybody. So we're not out here trying to make people think that we are greater or better than anybody else. We're out here trying to teach the truth about humanity. So what time is it? Is it time to go? No. Oh, boy. I really want to go down there and do something to Wells Fargo. I'm really getting really mad. I want to do something to Wells Fargo. I know y'all look at me and say, oh, he's a nice guy, but you don't know the thoughts I have. I'm burning down Master's house every night. Every night I go to bed, I'm burning down Master's house. Every night I go to sleep, I go to sleep dreaming about being a rebellious slave. I don't want to be Hercules. I want to be Nat Turner. I don't want to be Superman. I want to be Denmark Vesey. I don't want to be Spider-Man. I want to be Tucson. I want to be Dessalines. I want to be Bookman. I don't have to be no super. We got real superheroes. Real superheroes. What I need Superman for? I got Paul Robeson. What I need Superman for? I got Malcolm X. What I need Superman for? You know? Come on, y'all. We want reparations. We want it now. We want reparations. We want compensation and restitution for 450 years of slavery. See, I done messed up the voter registration drive, didn't I? People busy. Chesire, come on over here and say something about reparations. Come on. Huh? The census? Yes, everybody, please do your census. Come on, Chesire. Come on over here. Talk about reparations. I'll talk about the census before we go.